Hi guys, welcome back to my corner. So today I have a very interesting video for you. I came across a tag video from Emily Noel, and it was all about picking just her top five makeup products. So if you had to choose among your entire collection, what would be your top five? So if you'd like to know what my top five makeup essentials are, then keep on watching. Preparing another video the other day, and I put them all in this box right here, and I thought this is all of the items that I needed to do my face. And so it really challenged me to kind of break it down to the top five, the bare necessities. Also, I was thinking that this tag would be perfect for someone who maybe is just starting out with makeup and kind of want to know what are the basic things that they needed, things that are really going to get them through the day, maybe through work, and maybe just a little something extra if they need to go to a special location. If you're that person, this video is for you, but also just for anybody who loves makeup in general. So let's get started. So if I only had to pick five makeup products, I would start with a concealer. And my concealer is really no surprise to everybody. It's the Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer. I have it in the color medium dark warm. It's pretty much the same color as my skin tone, and so it's perfect for hiding those blemishes that I have or covering the dark circles. So as you can see, I have very dark circles under my eyes, so that's what I like to use this for. And it really just gives you kind of that refreshed look. Your face looks awake and healthy, and so I like to put them, you know, usually here in the middle. I have a little bit of redness, and what I like about this concealer also is that you can use it to cover any veins or redness on your eyes, and it's pretty much like an eye primer. That's one multitasking right there. Concealer for eyeshadow primer and also for hiding blemishes. And really, you can actually even use this concealer as a foundation if you'd like. And you can see that, you know, it kind of took away all of the redness around my face. And I like to put it here on my chin because it's my most problematic area. There, I just immediately look like I'm awake, like I'm a little bit more put together, right? And if you want to add more coverage, you can. I think I'm going to put some on my eyes as an eyeshadow primer and maybe bring it down here a little bit because I'm having some redness right here around the nose, and any other dark spots from, you know, pimple scars. Really, you can just skip foundation altogether if you like that simple look and you want kind of like your natural skin to come through. If I had to choose only five items, my next item would have to be a powder. I have combination to oily skin, so I definitely need some kind of mattifying powder to help me prolong the makeup. And just really with any kind of concealer, whether you have oily skin or dry skin, you really need that powder to set in the concealer that you put on your face. And so here's my favorite powder. This is by CIATE London. It is the Extraordinary Translucent Powder. And you know, for the longest time, my favorite, and I think everybody's favorite, has been the Laura Mercier translucent powder, and I like it too. But I like this because it has more of a brightening effect. So I'm gonna just powder my face, and I can't live without powder. I think if you have oily skin, you can skip the powder step. Pick an illuminating setting spray. So I'm liking this really nice base. And then I also use this CIATE London translucent powder for baking. So I like to bake around my chin, under my eyes. Another multitasking quality for the powders is that they can do a reverse contour. So you can see, just putting a powder there on my nose gives me that illusion of a pinched, you know, pointier nose.
Let's pretend you're not me
and you don't want to spend a lot of money on makeup or buying eyeshadows, and you only wanted to use one eyeshadow, something that you could use for every day. I've got you covered. I have so many eyeshadow palettes. I settled with this MAC Sweet as Cocoa blush. And yes, I know it's a blush, but you can actually use this as an eyeshadow as well. So what I like about this eyeshadow is, I mean this blush, is that it has a sheen to it. And so when you work with any kind of eyeshadow or blush that has a sheen to it, this is the color, by the way. Kind of see, there's kind of like a shimmer or sheen to this blush. Usually, an eyeshadow look requires different gradients of color, but when I use this, it kind of gives me that illusion using two or more shadows when you really just use one. It just depends on how the light reflects on your eyes. Depending on how I turn my head, you can see like the outer corners might be a little bit darker, you know, and the inner corners are a little bit brighter, and you know, the center of your lid appears to be brighter. So it looks like I probably use multiple eyeshadows, but I really just use one. And so I like that trick with shimmery eyeshadows. And you can bring it up a little bit. And normally I don't like to put shimmery eyeshadows above my crease, but this one you can actually get away with, because sometimes it looks like it's a matte eyeshadow and sometimes it's a shimmery eyeshadow depending on how you angle it. Get a MAC blush. You can even just get the refillable pan like this, and it's way cheaper. So it can get you a natural look, but also it can take you all the way to a nighttime look. If you're that person that really just wants a simple eye look for any occasion, this is it. I'm gonna use this under my eyes as well. Okay, so as you can see, I finished the eyes already off camera. I love this eyeshadow because depending on how you turn your face, you can see that the outer corners look a little bit darker. You know, I have that crease shade. It's as though I used a darker brown color, and so I like that. Next is bronzer. I actually put it on already while the camera was turned off. I like to use this blush as a bronzer as well. And so it kind of just gives you that sun-kissed look. And so I'll just put it again to kind of demonstrate, you know, and it's not gonna give you glitter all over your face. And I am usually very careful with that because I have oily skin. I don't want to have extra glitter and moisture on my face. So this is perfect for that. Lastly, we're gonna use this for what it truly is, as a blush. I love, love, love this blush. And just like that, we used this one product and made it do three different things. We used it as a blush, a bronzer, and as an eyeshadow. The next item on my top five is mascara. So I think everyone needs a mascara, no matter what look you're going for. Simple to nighttime, you need that mascara. And my favorite mascara at the moment is the Loreal Lash Paradise Mascara. Okay, there it is. Look at that. It just kind of gives you that fresh baby doll look. I love it. So hard for me to give up eyeliner. Eyeliner is one of my essential makeup products because of the way my eye shape is, the way I like my look to be. I just don't like it to be bare down here. And also, I like to give that illusion of fuller eyelashes. And so I also put eyeliner on my waterline and lash line right here, the upper lash line. And so it was hard to give that up, But I realized that mascaras can kind of give you that eyeliner look, right? So that way my bottom lashes don't look that bare. So I have my mascara on, my lashes are on point. Not too bad, right? Last but not the least, we have the lipsticks. For my fifth item, I chose Maybelline's Mauve for me in the color 373, right here. Oh, this is the color, by the way. And I like this because it's a satin finish. And it's not too nude. It's not a matte lipstick. I myself don't prefer lip glosses. I feel like I need a little bit more coverage, but this one is really the perfect in between. So you can definitely wear this for special occasions, but also for work, for school, you know, when you want that natural look. This is the final look. Simple look, but I really liked how this turned out. I've used up all my top five, so just to run down by them again, I have a powder from CIATE London. I have a mascara from Loreal. I have Urban Decay's concealer. I have the Maybelline lipstick. And then, of course, the ultimate multitasker, the MAC blush in the color Sweet as Cocoa. If I really had to choose, you know, my five makeup essentials, they would be it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please like this video if you enjoyed watching it. And also, if you're new here, please subscribe to my channel. I post videos once a week. Comment down below, what is your number one makeup go-to or makeup essential? Something that you can't live without. So please comment, respond. It will really help me out with my channel. And since this is kind of like a tag video, I wanna tag all my other friends from YouTube. I wanna give a shout out to Vanessa, Sheree, and Catherine, and maybe kind of challenge them to do their top five. I know each of them are really specific to makeup, skincare, or unboxings. Please go check them out as well. So that's it, guys. I'll see you back in my corner soon. Bye.